Like fellow fabricators, I'm always interested in tools that make my fabrication easier, more precise, and cleaner. I remember decades ago when I bought my first handheld plasma and how that made life easier compared to oxy-acetylene torches. Then it moved on to CNC plasma tables, and for the last 15 years I've enjoyed the ease of use and able to get parts that are more precise than hand cutting could ever achieve. But I've always lusted over fiber lasers, and fiber lasers from a price perspective always seem to be out of hand. Well, with these fiber systems from China, you can now build your own system. Well, with the fiber source, the chiller, and the head, that price was building, and then the time needed to wire everything up and put it on a table just made me sit on it, not motivated to get after it. Well, like many of you, I've also seen these fiber laser welders and amazed at what they can do, and always thought, man, that would make my fabrication life easier too, as it welds faster, it welds cleaner, and it welds pretty much anything. It can weld copper, stainless, mild steel. So I kind of sat on that also. But then I saw these videos that you could actually cut with these systems too. And then I had this great idea. It's like, well, why can't I buy this multi-use system that basically has all the parts put together for a fiber system and then put it onto the table? So I bought one.
So here's a little overview of the unit. It's a 2000 watt fiber laser. Bought it off Amazon, and I did that because I kind of wanted some, you know, security of something showed up that was broken, I could maybe have a refund or whatnot. But the company that I bought this from, this does have a little, or does have a representative from America, so I was able to contact him just to basically get updated starting instructions, and I'll show you what needed to happen for that. They need to update their manuals when they ship these. But a lot of these units, from what I can tell, are all using parts that are sourced, and then they're just basically assembling them together in packages. So they all kind of look the same. They all are using similar sources, similar laser sources, similar computers to run everything. So basically what happens is this 2000 watt unit was the biggest one I could find that would run off 240 volt single phase. And they're advertising it that you can, you know, weld single pass 3/8 inch. I think it probably could do a whole lot thicker than that. A lot of power coming out of this. And it comes with the wire feeder. And here's the gun. It's how you use this to adjust the focus, which still is kind of playing with. But you know, I've been using it for probably welded a good. And then this is the ground clamp per se. It's not, but basically what it's doing is you put it to wherever you're welding, like a table, and it makes sure you don't activate the laser unless this tip is contacting that. Sometimes I have to basically connect it here so that I can get to a weld that's kind of hard to get to. But it comes with tips that you can use 035 wire. They recommend a lot of nitrogen. This is very pure nitrogen for welds. I found that you can also use compressed air for welding mild steel, and impressed with how strong that is for what it is. You can tell that the weld might be a little bit more brittle, but the weld quality seems to be, there's no oxidation, there's no porosity. And there's some papers that I can link to in the description that shows that it's as strong as a normally shielded weld with, say, nitrogen, but it is a little bit more resist or not resistant to fatigue, or basically it becomes brittle. Let me show you how I turn this on. I'm using just a micro guard. I have compressed air that has the refrigerated liquid, refrigerated condenser to get the moisture out, but I put this in it because the air has to be really clean and void of moisture so it doesn't screw with the protective lenses. So that's a micro guard, sub-micron filter that filters out the particulates and moisture also. So to turn this on is kind of interesting. They have this that you pop out and it turns the computer on. And then you have to come down here and turn the chiller on, and that turns the pump on, and it has a chiller and a heater in it. The water needs to be above 20 C Celsius to even let the laser turn, and then it turn on, and then they recommend 28 Celsius and below for the actual operation. So this thing cycles quite a bit. I kind of wish it didn't cycle as much, but so it has cooling tubes that goes to the laser source, and then a couple cooling tubes that actually, come to the head themselves, and you can see them right there. So it keeps all this cool. And then after you turn that on, turn the condenser on or the chiller on, then you turn the main power source. And then this is where I had no instructions, but I had to basically get online. So you see there's a red light in there, and once that red light is going to turn, it's going to flash red and green here in about, it takes about 30 seconds. And once you do that, then you can turn, there's a breaker, this red and green, and then get you right there. And then you have to open this up and then turn this on to activate the laser. And it has to be done in that step or it won't work. And let's just say I was freaking out when I first got it, because it would put out a red laser beam here, but when you pull the trigger, it did nothing. So it's able to get in contact with them. They got in contact with me pretty quick after I had to download a WhatsApp and get their numbers, but they got me through it. Of course, there's videos online. This is a very generic screen of how that works. Comes with presets and things of that nature. Like you go here, I don't want to say that. Carbon steel 2.0 export, and it brings in all the settings. There's the chiller coming on.
Here I'm cutting out the bracket with the CNC plasma table. This bracket will hold the welding gun or cutting gun now, fiber laser, to be mounted onto the table itself. I really like this metal brake, magnetic metal brake. It really makes bending these small brackets pretty straightforward and easy, quick. Has all sorts of attachments. Here's the bracket that goes around the gun. Have a little lip for it to keep it from moving down. And here's some welding with the fiber laser. I really like it with these small nuts and such because it doesn't put a lot of heat into it. Still getting used to it. You have to let the wire kind of push the gun and not fight it. It's hard for me to do right now, but it makes a very clean weld. And I'm just using compressed air for the shielding gas right now, which is around about 25 PSI through the regulator. very nice weld, clean, no porosity. As you see, it penetrates very nicely.
So for electrical, I had to figure out how to basically activate this switch from the computer, which is, you know, plasma on. So I took this cover off, traced the wires back to the unit. Let's open up the unit here. And basically I put this, I use these jacks because they're nice and they're protective when you're not using it. But on this control unit, I was able to find start and ground and was able to put this unit, this jack in, so I can connect to my control box for the plasma on, which starts the arc. And in this case, it will start the laser arc or laser beam.
So it comes with this cutting tip. Slower than the plasma torch. So we'll see.
So I want to go through the settings here. From what they said to the manufacturer, you put the, you know, cutting wattage. I'm going to start out at 1500. But then your wobble length needs to be 0.1. And that's all they send to, you know, get this thing in cutting mode. Of course, you have the head on there with the cutting nozzle. They give you a very wide range of air pressures, but I just have shop air at probably 110 PSI into it. And then there's our signal wire to turn it on from that bird nest of wires, which is the back of it's, you know, the control box to, you know, here is the connection to, you know, have it to turn on. There's no arc voltage, right? So we'll have to figure a torch high control later in a different video. Also, you know, make sure your plasma cutters unplugged from the control box. Notice that if you keep that plugged in, then it actually might trip that on. So I got a program for a bottle opener that will see if that works. Also, safety first. These are the glasses, laser glasses that they sent. Wear them. I've noticed that this thing does put out laser beams in places, especially when you're filming it. You can't see it by your eye, but when the camera sees it, it's kind of a purple flash. So you got to be wearing these. You know, the actual laser tables that you buy have an enclosure, and it's probably for a good reason. So there's no one else in my shop, no animals, no dogs, but wear these. All right, now we try it. Ah, it's working! Wow. Heats up the back of that plate pretty good. Wow. Get that focused. Wow. Look at that. I'm going to try to take it out. That pops right out. Can you see that? I'm going to have to work on the setting some. It's warm. But the kerf width is small. got some slag on this, so I'm gonna have to figure out, it might be focus, it might be, man, look at that. I'll take a picture of that. Wow. Wow. Look how small. I don't know. I can't get it. The kerf width is that. All right. We're doing this quarter inch at 40 inches per minute at 2,000 watts. I don't know why it's doing that for. So it's leaving a lot of slag. I think it has to do with the focus. If you know, leave in the comments. But that's quarter inch steel. Man, it cut all the way through three sides of that. Man, it's a little warm, but not on that downward side. The only thing I could think of is I didn't really have it flat in there. I just had a clamp on it. So I'm thinking maybe it got over here and got way out of focus for some reason. But then it cut. Then it started cutting fine over here. So I think that's when the torch height control is going to come in handy. But man, it will cut through quarter inch steel. Maybe y'all, any laser experts out there can tell me, you know, do I need to bring the focus down, up? How do I get rid of that slag? Is it more air pressure? Let me know. But I'm impressed with it. I mean, that's a whole lot better of a cut than plasma can give.